Hey, what's going on? It's Doug from CSR Promotions, CSRPromo.com. We're back here with our first DJ that we're interviewing about the whole situation on why a rapper from Orlando hasn't blown up yet. I'm here with 4 Stacks, Resident Cleo's DJ, City Boy. Well, you know what? Let me let him tell you what he is.
What's up, man? I'm Mr. 4000, Cleo's, Firestone, Element, everywhere, Envy, all kind of places. You know what I'm saying? We try to get my name out there, but it's a lot. The reason that I feel that rapping hasn't really blown up because we ain't really got no loyalty in the O.
When you say loyalty, is that from the rappers to the DJs, the DJs to the rappers, the people to the rappers? Who is the loyalty? Is it the whole circle? Or?
Well, basically, it's like a lot to do with everybody. You know, you got certain artists that don't fuck with certain DJs. I'm sorry, you got a lot of artists that fuck with certain DJs. A lot of DJs that mess with a lot of artists. It's just a lot of cliques, and everybody just need to be like one big team. That's how we're gonna blow up, is everybody work together.
Yeah, there's cliques. There's cliques in every circle. There's Grand Hustle, there's CTE, there's stuff like that in Atlanta. But out here, I know there's certain cliques. We'll keep them. They know who they are. But at the same time, there's other artists that aren't with the clique, period. Is their music lacking? Is their approach lacking? Maybe they're not getting their name out there to you guys? Like,
well, I mean, it's a lot of artists in Orlando that do a lot of ass kissing. Yeah, I said it has nothing to do with them. I said that certain artists are really gutter. They keep it to the streets. They do what they do. And it's whatever. But it's a lot of artists in Orlando that do a lot of ass kissing.
Okay, so we're trying to fix the issue here. So what? We'll speak just speak for yourself as 4000, 4 Stacks as a DJ. How can an artist get you some music that you'll actually listen to and possibly play if you like it? What are the steps for that? What's the best way?
Basically, if an artist wants to get to me, they can either email me at 4stacks@yahoo.com, or they can either bring me to Cleo's on Saturday nights or Tuesday nights, or either any time in the daytime from 12 to 7 at Cleo's. I'm always there.
So when they bring it to you, are you just going to play it right on the spot? Or what's the best time to give it to you while you're DJing, when you're taking a break? What's the best way for somebody that doesn't know you?
Well, like me, I've been showing love for years. Pretty much, if you bring me anything, I don't care if it's 5,000 people in the room. I'm going to let you see right then and there if your record's hot. That's the only way. Because if you bring it to me early, nobody's in the room, and I put it on, okay, it's hot. If I put it on in the room, and it's like 300 people in the room, and it flops, there you have it.
Yeah, so I guess if you're a new artist and you never met 4 Stacks or you don't really have a name out here, maybe give them the record, introduce yourself maybe at the end of the night when you could actually introduce yourself to him and tell him to check it out. Maybe not in front of the 5,000 people because he may never give you another shot if your first joint doesn't work. So, you know, get to know him. He said he'll play it. So, I mean, I expect whoever's watching this to at least attempt to get it played from him. You know what I'm saying? He's giving you the floor, so that's the first step, I guess, in getting the music out there. We got to get it played, and it's got to be good. And I guess no ass kissing, and stop with the clicks. If you're with a certain click, mess with everybody. I mean, that's the only way that DJ click's going to mess with you.
And I mean, like, a lot of artists, the problem that I have with them is you might come to Cleo's and give me a record and be my best friend, but if I come in the room with certain big-name DJs, walk right past me.
So I've seen it too. Like, somebody may look at him as, oh, he's a city boy, and they'll go talk to Disco when there's a group of people. But as soon as he's DJing, you're going to go talk to him because he's on the floor. So it's like, you got to show love to these DJs. They're not stupid. He knows who you are. So if he sees you and you walk by him, he's taking it personal. I mean, it is personal. So, you know, network with everybody. They may not be DJing that night, but they may spin your thing tomorrow. So I guess closing out, you know, I appreciate it, 4 Stacks. He's telling you straight up how to get your music played out here and telling you why he doesn't think we're anybody's blown up from here yet. So I guess, like, that's the first step that we can take from a DJ's mouth out here to start the movement.
That's what's up, man. It's your way, Doug. I love y'all CSR Promotions, man. Y'all fuck with 2010 Red Team, bitch.